إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأصلي وأسلم وأبارك على سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فصلوات الله وسلامه عليك سيدي أبا القاسم يا رسول الله. All praises and thanks be to Allah, the Lord of all mankind, jinns and all that exist, and may peace and the blessing be upon his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, upon his companions, upon his family, and all those follow him till the day of judgment. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Oh, you believe, fear Allah as Allah should be feared, and don't die except in the state of Islam. Dear respected brothers and sisters, before I start my khutbah today, and inshallah ta'ala we will meet monthly in khutbah, the concept of Jumaa Khutbah, as we learned from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that the khutbah should be related with what's going around us. يعني if we are in Ramadan, it is not the time to talk about Muharram, for example. We are in Ramadan. It is good to talk about Ramadan. So the definition of the khutbah, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Arabic, التفاعل مع أحداث الأسبوع, the reaction and interaction with the events and incidents of last week. So sometimes you will go to many places and you find the khatib is talking about something out of the life. He is talking about something not related even with the ummah. Sometimes he is talking about something not related with the daily life of Muslims. So the khutbah should be related, as we learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, with our life. We have to deal in the khutbah because you are coming just once a week. You have to get something from the khutbah. When you go home, you remember that you heard and listened to something. You benefited from that khutbah in order to use it in your week, in your life. Dear brothers, now we are after Ramadan. Ramadan said bye-bye, goodbye, see you next year. Ramadan left. And we are after Ramadan. I noticed from my travel, from my life in the UK, in my back home, in many Muslim countries, that when Ramadan finished, the Muslims take holiday till next Ramadan. Khalas. The life of, they are now in holiday till next Ramadan. They are very active, doing something special in Ramadan, and after Ramadan, khalas, we finished. So we will meet Ramadan next year. Yaakhi, are you guaranteed that you will be next year in Ramadan? It is not guaranteed. You will go out, any one of us, he might have an accident after 1 hour and he will leave this life. It is not guaranteed. Now, before I start what we need after Ramadan, I would like to give you a quick introduction to keep it in your mind, to remember what is the relationship between Ramadan and after Ramadan. We mentioned in Ramadan, and everyone listened to that speech or these hadiths in many places. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا جاء رمضان, if Ramadan comes, فتحت أبواب الجنة وغلقت أبواب النار وصفدت الشياطين. Three things. When Ramadan comes, the doors and gates of Jannah will be opened. It will be a good chance for you to move and get more and good results in Ramadan. And the gates of hellfire will be closed in order to give you a chance. And ash-shayateen will be tight. Shaitan will be in the corner. It will be tight. But what's after Ramadan? Ramadan finished. We are in Shawwal. Just to remember that the gates of Jannah will not be open like it was in Ramadan. Not. Remember this. And the gates of hellfire will be opened because this is after Ramadan. But the main thing, ash-shaytan will be free. He will move ash-shayateen because it was chained, it was tied, it was in the corner. But after Ramadan, what will happen? They will be free. So will be our situation is difficult because it is after Ramadan. So ash-shayateen, and remember this, ash-shaytan consider that the month of Shawwal, where we are now, is the month of revenge, شهر الانتقام. الشيطان, he noticed that you are going to al-masjid, صلاة التراويح, you are reciting the Quran. Sometimes I ask somebody, what did you do in Ramadan? He said, Alhamdulillah, I completed al-Quran in the first week of Ramadan. What did you do in Ramadan? Alhamdulillah, I completed the Quran 3 times in Ramadan. Ash-shaytan is watching that you are completing the Quran, that you are doing Qiyam, and ash-shaytan is tied. What will happen? Ash-shaytan now wants to revenge. He wants to punish you. He wants to stand against you. He wants to divert you to another route. This is what we need to understand, that after Ramadan, ash-shaytan will be very active. It will be moving, but what we notice, from the first day after Ramadan, and all of us will notice this, that your psychology in Ramadan is totally different from the time after Ramadan. You feel that your closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than outside Ramadan. This is the truth. You notice that, alhamdulillah, we wake up for as-suhoor, we go for Salatul Fajr, we go for Qiyam. So your personality is different from outside Ramadan. So Ramadan is very special. So from the first day, and Al-Eid huwa yawmul hajj al-akbar, after Eid al-Adha, and after Ramadan is the day of prize because it is after Ramadan. What will happen? In the first day of Eid, you will find that ash-shaytan is achieving good scores from the first day. The people did not wake up to Salat al-Fajr from the first day. So dear brothers, you will notice that ash-shaytan is now active and he began to achieve good scores against Muslims and many Muslims in the UK. I don't want to go outside this country. They consider that, alhamdulillah, Ramadan finished, and the day of Ma'asiyah will start on the day of Eid. One of the cities, I mentioned this, that during the Eid, they are doing Al-Khamr, they are celebrating, because they are celebrating Eid. Dear brothers, we have to be very careful. And in my khutbah, I selected 5 very beautiful ayat from the Quran to keep them in our minds what we need to remember after Ramadan. The first ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. So the Quran is talking to you, Ahmed, Mahmoud, sister. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Selected. It is not general. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. So you are part of those who are calling. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان ومن يتبع خطوات الشيطان فإنه يأمر بالسوء والفحشاء. This ayah, when I went to the tafsir and stood with it, يا أيها الذين, oh you who believe, don't follow the steps and the commands of الشيطان. فإنه يأمر بالفحشاء والمنكر ومن يتبع خطوات الشيطان فإنه يأمر بالفحشاء. يا أيها الذين آمنوا, who you believe, don't follow the commands and the steps of الشيطان. And this is the program. الشيطان is trying to put for you after Ramadan. يا أخي القرآن, أخي, it is enough, ما شاء الله, you achieve something in Ramadan. So many Muslims follow الشيطان directly or indirectly. لا تتبعوا. So الشيطان, remember, is not simple. لو كانت تقى, this is very beautiful in Arabic, we say it, لو كانت تقى بغير العلم شرف لكان أشرف خلق الناس إبليس. If you want to compare yourself with Iblis, Iblis is more educated than you. الشيطان is more knowledgeable than you. الشيطان is not easy. But there is no taqwa. This person or this الشيطان, this creator, is trying to divert us from the root. So this is number one. لا تتبعوا خطوات. He has a program. He needs us to follow. And after Ramadan, the start of the program will take place. After Ramadan, and I noticed that after Ramadan, alhamdulillah, many Muslims, sorry to say this, think that they completed everything and now they have to take rest. Ayah number two, second verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كالتي نقضت غزلها من بعد قوة أنكاثا. The meaning of this ayah, there is a lady making some sewing, and when she finished her job, you will say to her, oh, mashallah, you done a good job, you done a good jacket. And after you say to her that you done good job, she will take everything off. I'm saying to you, you are doing something good. You are damaging what you are doing. Somebody is a good chef. He done very good job, very nice food. And you are saying to him, thank you very much. You done, mashallah, good food. Then he take the food and he throw it like this. I'm saying to you, you are doing good job. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كالتي نقضت غزلها من بعد قوة أنكاثا. Don't be like the lady who done good job and after that she throw everything away. And this is our problem, brothers after and sister, after Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, we done good job, but it is not guaranteed that everything is achieved. It is not guaranteed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted. So we need to continue. Alhamdulillah, we started in very good job in Ramadan regarding, for example, some of them. He recites something about Salatu al-Duha. And mashallah, they are praying Salatu al-Duha. And they are very, very beautiful ahadith talking about the rewards of praying Salatu al-Duha. And sometimes they are praying Salatu al-Witr al-Qiyam, which is something very important I would like to mention here. That in Ramadan, من قام رمضان, whoever make قيام in Ramadan, فكأنما غفرت له ذنوبه, whoever قيام رمضان. And قيام رمضان is صلاة التراويح. After Ramadan, what will happen? Even brothers and sisters, they don't pray صلاة الوتر. Even صلاة الوتر, خلاص, الحمد لله, we finished Ramadan. There is two things in the Sunnah I would like to mention for my brothers and sisters. You should do it whatever was the condition. Number one is Salatul Witr. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned many hadith, but I would like to mention one of them, that when you pray Salatul Witr, You are like making qiyam. Salatul Witr. Salatul Witr. Salatul Witr could be one rak'ah, could be three rak'ah, could be five rak'ah or more. Witr, it means that it is not, or it will be like one, three, five, and so on. So Salatul Witr, many brothers, which is very common, and usually I say this to them, that don't miss Salatul Witr, because Salatul Witr related with Al-Qiyam. So when you pray Salatul Witr, even one rak'ah, you, as the person who, and this is for my sister as well, who done something called Qiyam. So don't miss Salatul Witr after Salatul Isha in these days after Ramadan. The other thing, brother, which I have to mention it, that the Sunnah, which you should replace it and do it even you miss it, Sunnatul Fajr. A Sunnah of Salatul Fajr. Sometimes the people are wake up late and he finds the sun is set and khalas, he missed Salatul Fajr. Then what he will do? He just pray two rak'ah of fard as qada to replace it. A Sunnah, which Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam focused, that Salatu, a Sunnah of Al Fajr should be prayed even you came late. You have to do it. So Salatul Fajr, when you wake up and you miss the time of Al-Fajr, don't just pray Al-Fard. You have to pray Al-Sunnah as well. Even you miss it as Al-Witr, sometimes you sleep, you miss Salatul Witr, you have to replace it. You have to do it. You have to do Qada for Al-Witr even next day. So dear brother, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا. She is doing, mashallah, good Qiyam, good Siyam. It is good to continue. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان وأتبعه ستة من شوال. These days, and I think we still have about 10 days in شوال, it will be over. Don't miss to pray 6 days of شوال in order to achieve that you are praying the rest of the year. Fast, yeah. To fast 6 days in this month, you are like who is fasting the whole year of the الدهر here, it means the whole sana. So dear brother, the second ayah, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي غَزَلَتْ نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا. We don't want to destroy what did we do in Ramadan. The third ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Al-yaqeen here in the Quran means the death. يعني continue worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till you die. Many ignorant people, بعض الجاهلين, they think that خلاص, I have اليقين, I have satisfaction, no need for me to go and pray. There is some people who don't understand the Islam. Many of big mistakes, and I think many of you travel to Mecca, and they pray in Al-Kaaba, in Masjid Al-Haram, and Masjid Al-Nabawi. I used to pray in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa every day, Al-Fajr and Al-Isha. I lived near to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. If you pray in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, Al-Fard, you will be rewarded as 500 Salah. And if you pray in Al-Masjid Al-Haram, 100,000 Salah. So one of them made calculation, and he said, oh, I went 1 week to Al-Masjid Al-Haram in Mecca, so I prayed 1 week, so no need for me to pray 2 years, because this is enough. Alhamdulillah, I have al-yaqeen. Al-yaqeen here in the Quran means the death. And the meaning of 500 salah or 100,000 in reward. So when you pray in al-Masjid al-Haram, Salatul Dhuhr, you pray just one fard, but you are rewarded as 100,000. You are rewarded, but you are not prayed 100,000 salah. So wa'bud rabbaka hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqeen. I would like to give you a beautiful example of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is our leader. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his house in Al-Madina, nearby to Al-Masjid, his home, just the wall between the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Al-Masjid, Al-Masjid al-Nabawi. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before his death, before he died, he has humma. He was very hot, very sick. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him, try to stand up to go and to pray jama'ah, which is next to the place. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and anyone of us, if he is tired, we have excuse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us permission sometimes to pray while sitting, to pray in home, to pray while you are sleeping, and so on. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was very hot, and he tried to stand up. Aisha tried to help him. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam little bit stand up, then fell down. He was very tired. Then they brought cold water and drop it on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in order to stand and go to pray. So this is why wa'bud rabbaka hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqeen. Don't think that you completed, mashallah, you fasted last Ramadan, so alhamdulillah, you are fully satisfied, completed, and no need for you to do these things. So we have to continue worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the fourth ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَا إِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَا إِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. If you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase the rewards for you. وَلَا إِن شَكَرْتُمْ, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many Muslims, brothers and sisters, think that they have achieved good results in Ramadan. Yahi, what is the guarantee that your deeds has been accepted? What is the guarantee? The only thing is the amal, the hope to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, accept our deeds. We thank you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you gave us this chance. Dear brothers, any opportunity, it is like a flight. It is like bird. If you don't catch the opportunity will go. Sometimes you will find some sale for one day. You will go and buy. After the end of the day, it will go, it finished, khalas. You catch that opportunity. If you don't catch the opportunity, it will fly. Ramadan came. And alhamdulillah, wallahi, this year I was very happy when I asked some people about the last 10 days of Ramadan. What they say? Alhamdulillah, we make qiyam for the 10 days because we don't know which day will be Laylatul Qadr. So we started from the night of 19 and we continue till the end of Ramadan to catch that night. But sometimes others did not care, did not find that this is an opportunity. I want to say that, Ya Allah, thank you, Ya Allah. You gave us the opportunity to attend Ramadan. Now Ramadan is finished. Now what is the next step we have to do after the end of Ramadan? وَلَا إِن شَكَرْتُمْ, to say thank you, Ya Allah. But Ya Allah, please accept what did we do in Ramadan. Ya Allah, accept. This is the main thing. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept what did we do in Ramadan. So dear brothers, we have to continue. And there are many opportunities we have to do. Many things to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shawwal has 6 days to fast. We have Al-Ayyam Al-Bid. Last week, I think it was Friday, Saturday and Sunday, I think. It was 13, 14 and 15 of the month. So imagine that, mashallah, you fasted Shawwal 3 days. And you fasted them on the 3 white days of Shawwal. Look how Allah said. So, Ya Allah, we thank you very much that you give us the chance to attend Ramadan. And we keep asking, Ya Allah, give us chance to attend next Ramadan. Ya Allah, give us chance to accept what did we do in Ramadan. So we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he give us the opportunity. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear respected brothers, the final ayah, I would like to finish it, my khutbah today, which is related with what is after Ramadan. Dear brother, you have to be humble in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You keep asking Allah بالتذلل, asking Allah, don't think that you are arrogant, you are important. No, no, we are nothing. We are a human being. Sometimes you drink some water, then you find yourself that you are about to die because the water has, or you eat something, it block your throat. We are nothing. Sometimes, wallahi, akhi, some people, one of my friends, he told me about his father. His father is Syrian, waiting for the visa to come to this country for 3 years. He is in Egypt, and they gave him the visa to come. So he has to come maybe tomorrow or next week. And his father, because he's a friend of mine, he said, my father is a specialist in swimming, in something very special. So when he go to swimming pool, the whole people are watching that man. Strong man, good swimmer. His son told me. He said, he got the visa, we are waiting for him. He's coming next week or next day. And he went to the swimming pool in Cairo, in a hotel. And he finished his swimming, and he took his bag with his friend. He said to his friend, oh, I feel some pain in my chest. He said to him, okay, let's have a seat to drink some cold thing. Maybe you are tired. And in a few seconds, this person passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him rahmah. Seconds, without any introduction. He is fit man, good swimmer, and in seconds he passed away. Listen to this ayah, brothers. Don't think, start myself, that we are heroes. No. We should be very humble, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us. Otherwise, we will be big losers. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلِ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ is building Al-Ka'ba, Al-Qawa'id, the pillars of Al-Ka'ba. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا طب he is doing very good job. Is he doing any bad things? He asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after he is building Al-Ka'ba, Ya Allah, taqabbal minna. So now when we are praying al-fard here, for example, al-jum'ah or any salah, we make assalamu alaykum, then we say assalamu alaykum. What is the first sentence we say after assalam? We say astaghfirullah. Is it correct or not? I say astaghfirullah. I am praying, I am not doing wrong things. The first thing we do, even after a salah, we say astaghfirullah al-azim al-ladhi la ilaha illahu. Dear brothers, we have to be very humble and keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, accept our deeds in Ramadan. So we have to continue in this way, dear brothers, after Ramadan, in order to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this from us in order to reach next Ramadan. Allahumma taqabbal minna innaka anta as-sami'u al-alim. وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم اجعلنا من عتقاء شهر رمضان اللهم إنا نسألك أن تتقبل منا ما قمنا به في رمضان اللهم تقبل منا ما عملنا في رمضان اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يشهدون رمضان العام القادم يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يقولون ويعملون ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم إنا نسألك أن تفرج كرب المسلمين في سوريا وفي العراق وفي فلسطين وفي مينمار وفي كل مكان اللهم إنا نسألك أن تذيق المسلمين حلاوة النصر وأن تذيق أعداءنا مرارة الهزيمة يا رب العالمين وأنت يا مقيم الصلاة أقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. Allah.